Hello friend, welcome to my video. We practice with a small example like above. In this video, I explain how to configure basic security on Cisco ASA. Your network is divided into three roles which are outside, inside, and DMZ. We have an example with a network with a web server. In this recipe, you will protect a web server by connecting it to your Cisco ASA DMZ network. In addition to protecting the web server, the DMZ also protects the rest of the network. The basic ASA configuration setup is three interfaces connected to three network segments. The ISP network segment is connected to the Gigabit Ethernet 0/2 interface and labeled outside with a security level of 0. The internal network has been connected to Gigabit Ethernet 0/1 and labeled as inside with a security level of 100. The DMZ segment, where the web server resides, is connected to Giga Ethernet 0/0 and labeled as DMZ with a security level of 50. The ASA's outside interface is configured with an IP address obtained from the ISP. Here you can see that the ASA's inside interface is set with the IP address of 192.168.1.1, and it is the default gateway for the internal hosts. The DMZ interface is configured with the IP address of 10.10.10.1, and it is the default gateway for hosts on the DMZ network segment. Now, you need to the configuration so that users on the internet can access our web server on TCP port 80 and port 443. Use ObjectNAT for this task, and the ASA will translate TCP port 80 on the web server to look like TCP port 80 on the outside. Next, the ASA will translate TCP port 443 on the web server to look like TCP port 443 on the outside. Remember, on an ASA, traffic that goes from a lower security interface is denied when it goes to a higher security interface. For that reason, hosts on the outside with security level 0 cannot connect to hosts on the DMZ with security level 50. Because traffic from the outside to the DMZ network is denied by the ASA with its current configuration, users on the internet cannot reach the web server despite the NAT configuration. You need to explicitly permit this traffic. This means the configuration needs to permit traffic destined to 10.10.10.10 on port 80 and port 443. Next, configure NAT to allow hosts from inside segment to go out to the internet. You create a NAT rule that allows hosts on inside segment to connect to the internet. Because these hosts use private IP addresses, you need to translate them to ASA's outside interface IP address that is routable on the internet. Next, you configure the DHCP server for the inside segment. In this session, I will cover how to enable ICMP inspection to allow ping traffic passing ASA. You can now browse the internet using any computer that connects to the inside interface. As always, if you found this post useful, then subscribe to my YouTube channel. Help me 500,000 subscribers.